everyone loves dumbbells. Usually we associate them with doing curls. But hey, we can put them over our head as well. All right, so dumbbells pressing movements. We have a lot of good ones. A lot of people will sit on something. You can even sit on the floor with your legs straight out. It actually makes you engage that core a little bit more. But you can stand up for them. And even then, you want to think about squeezing your butt, squeezing your core to give yourself a solid, stable bottom so you're not all wiggly wobbly, wacky, wavy arms person. All right, so I got some nice, good, light dumbbells here because if I'm going to be doing high reps, I want to make sure that I'm still doing quality movement at the end. If I'm going to be doing these tired in a workout, I want to make sure that I can do them at the end of the workout. So err on the side of too light if you can at first. So for pressing, you can, if you're just doing a strict press, shoulder press, where there's no extra movement, right, you can either do them both at the same time, and I like to call this the hammer way. You come straight up, or you can even face them out, a little more external rotation of the shoulder, and come straight up, or you can even alternate each one, or same, you can, it's up to you, really. The main thing on all of them is that when I come up at the top, no matter what, I'm not coming out, I'm not coming forward, I'm coming straight up, I'm trying to track over my ear. And when I lock out, I'm covering my ear with my shoulder, okay? And even if I'm here, I'm covering my ear with my shoulder and my elbows are locked. I am fully locked out as much as I can. And when I come down, they're either right on top of my shoulder, they don't have to touch necessarily, or but they're not in front. This is gonna make them a lot harder to put strain on your wrist. And they're not too far back. That means you're arching a lot. All right, so engage my core. I like to think of it like a roller coaster ride. When you start and you're like, and you're getting ready for it. And you just throw your arms up and lock it out. All right, now, if I'm doing something with a little extra movement, not just my shoulders, like a dumbbell push press, I will want to most likely do them at the same time. So not alternating. Alright, again, you can choose how you're holding it. Just make sure it's the same for both. The push press means that there's some leg movement in it. It's really more of a leg movement. Think of it like an Oompa Loompa. Oompa Loompa. Doompa doo doo. This is going to initiate the movement. Just a little knee bend, whole foot on the ground, knee bend, jump. So I'm knee bend jumping, but I'm doing it with dumbbells. When I lock out, I'm not rebending my knee. So it's an oompa and then a loompa. Oompa. Oompa. That's all it is. It's just the oompa. So knee bend to get that drive. And then I'm throwing them up and still locking out the same way I did around my shoulders and still making sure I'm not coming out here. Oh my God, that's much harder. And I'm not coming out here. You always want to think bone on bone. So wrist on elbow, on shoulder, on hip, on knee, on ankle. All right, coming down. So that is the push press. If it's in a workout, ideally you're choosing a weight you can do unbroken, but you're still resetting each time for them, all right? If you get to the point where you can string them together and control this down, go ahead, that's fine. But make sure it's always, always, always in